And all the time. Praise the Lord. Oh, you guys look so beautiful. And pink. Amen. It's loud, but it's beautiful. Praise God. So, welcome into the house of the Lord here at Midway Samoan Assembly of God for yet another service to give God the glory for placing on this earth mothers, amen, as we celebrate mothers, amen. Amen. She shall be praised. Amen. Praise God. Amen. No matter what. Amen. Praise God. Amen. It's the word of God, amen. It's the word of God. It's in the word of God. It's not my word. Praise God. A woman who fears the Lord is to be praised. And I believe that every single woman in, not just in our women's ministry, but in our church, Midway Samoan Assembly of God, I believe we are all God-fearing women. Amen. Women of God. God-fearing women are to be praised. And therefore, we celebrate you today. We celebrate you this evening, and so we're just going to start with this song. Feel free to stand up and praise God with a clap, praise God with a dance. You can also sit for those of you who are unable to do so. Amen. And then amen. Tamata lofa ile atua, ete tauia ile viinga, ete tauia ile mamalu o ie pa ia, eona le ola, leo tato maua ma tato mafai, eona tato fatasi, ila loifa le neifale, ile nei tula, suapo Yesu. Thank you. amene. O tata mala mama o hana o setinana te tangoa. E ui lava ina, it seemed like she didn't have, like she was in her darkest hour. And it was the last of her hope, but she continued to trust God and have faith and pray that she will have a child. Amen? I'm going to invite you to stand and go walk around and greet each other, especially our lovely mothers. And then if you are a visiting mother, please make your way to the beautiful chairs that have been reserved just for you. Amen? It's not just about Midway mothers. It's about all mothers. Amen? So we welcome you, our visiting mothers. Please make your way to the beautiful chairs on the right. If you can, if you will. You're not obligated to, but you are welcome to it. Amen? So walk around and shake somebody's hand. Greet somebody with a smile. And bless them this evening with the love of Jesus' name. Tell somebody Happy Mother's Day. Amen?
It's a good one.
So to the West Hound, if I would be home of a tire, to the near Fiafi, amen. So we're just gonna go ahead and start giving God the worship and the praise that He deserves. Hallelujah, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Your kingdom.
your name.
Jehovah is your name. Fa amanuia oe lea tua Yamato or Lota, what we farmer mean, I your matto letina, farmer me, I your matto tato, in a fight at Otama, on Yulu, on Yana, and Matama, Anna, Anna Yatioi, Malawa, Fiona Paia, no matto tua, Fafitai, that tua, Fafitai, Fafitai, on our Wata, Uo, Mato, on a Tina, me, on the day, on a Tina, the Tao Yatioi. Oni tina e ana ana yate oi no mātou tamā. Aga le nei na wafio, le nei afi afi no mātou atua. Ia e aga le nei I le o le atu na e na wupu. Ia anu mane mana na wafio mpa ia. Ina ia pai mpa u I le yo mātou loto. Ina ia tupu maona mai ai se fua le nei. A wana mātou ngā lenga ni atua tutono lau e kāresia. Whamaiwia foi la wafio lo mātou atua. I prokalama o tāpena ina ele mafutaka tina. Ina ia batu ai se whiau e whamaiwia e se loto. O se o asi asi mai, o se o whamaiwai, o se e lei tarina o Yesu. Ina ia veo e kiwiso e wha mō lātou ali, mō lātou whaola. Whamanuia whapitua o tama, ia mātou tina mātutua, lele ia kiwi. Ia maua pere ola, maua pere mālosi, maua pere atua le oli oli e me lue pere mō oe, malau ngā lega. Whamanuia foi oe le tua, si o mātou tina whalea ngāne asu. E hui lava no mātou atua, e tala vōu no nōlanga. Mātou te whata I nātou, e e umaro no whani le ne hewhiawhi. Ia e amare le ia angel, whālo to tele. Mau le loto mau la. Mau le loto e ori, ori a te ori, I so se mea. Ia vea ori a o se ti nā whalea ngana, to tōru mātou e kālesia. O se whamanianga ia e mātou, ae whāsirisiri ai, o se whamanianga ia te oe. Whamanuia I no meo lama, whamanuia I no na mātou whau, ia iai lau whamaro roa I no na tino, ia iai koe lau whamanianga I tu tōru o rena āina. Ia I ia I whamaro ngalo mai o mātou tangata, yō mātou aleu, yō mātou reanga, yā mātou o masara whaipea, ia I anga re nei whamaro ngalo, whamamama I oi rea tua yō mātou rei tangata. O le mātou te tau rea, mātou te whata I nā atu luma lo nofari e ala le ufitanga le mana o le toto oi ke miso e ala lo lawa suafa Yesu a nene, ma nene. Ya vi ile tu e nei tu la fiafi e men. But our tuya tinayo the tofia e alta to la fama ni afi afi. Sina upu famalosi for offering tonight. Mole ne lua kwe mito mta upwe iva, fai upwe ono na fitu e fapea. A o la ule ne e fai atu, o lea u e ti iti ana saitu e lulu, e iti iti fo I ana sele sele mai. A o lea u e tele ana lulu, e tele fo'i ana sele sele mai. Ia taitoa tasi ma fo'ai e pei ama whiriwhiri ona loto. Aua ma le tīngā, aua fo'i ma le whaatanga wina, a wā e alofa le tua I le fo'ai ma le loto na lie. Amen. Aua e te fo'ai ona sembea ua tato ma sani ai. Aua fo'i o te fo'ai ona ua whaatawana wina no fo'ai. Aua fo'i te fo'ai ana ua te o mea e maua. A ia fo'ai mana o loto marie, ma ia whai mele nei lo fo'ai, I whamana wia ma le tue a te tātou, amen. But this I say, he who sows sparingly will also reap sparingly, and he who sows bountifully will also reap bountifully. So let each one give as he proposes in his heart, not grudgingly or of necessity, for God loves a cheerful giver, amen. Yes. Father in heaven, we thank you for all your blessings that you have bestowed upon us. Father, I pray for your church that they may give with a cheerful heart. Bless those who give today. Show them your love in a mighty way because of their obedience.
bless this offering in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Welcome into the house of the Lord here at Midway, Samoan Assembly of God. All our visitors, let's give a hand for all our visitors this evening. Thank you so much for taking the time out of your very busy schedules to come and fellowship with us this evening, amen? And praise God with us and break bread with us, amen? And then I'd also like to greet all our elders, Tato Tina, Matama, Matutua. Amen. Am I spotting what that's what you want to know? That's true. Amen. Love my yogi, not in my church, but I that's why you love. Love for my only for now, for my real in my matto. Love for you, for you, no matter what I tell you, it's why, amen. For my Lucia, for you, my toy, and I eat. I'm only 42. I'm still young. Yeah, Father, I look for you, Tato, for now, we till you lay up, yappy, amen. Amen, young people. Thank you for taking the time out of your very busy schedules to come and celebrate your moms or celebrate our Midway moms or celebrate the moms in your life, in the world. Amen. Thank you, worship team. I'm sorry. So without further ado, I'm going to turn it over to our speaker. But before she comes up, I just want to say a few things about her this evening. Amen. I'm older than her. Praise God. What blesses me the most is that she's gone through so many things. And regardless of what she goes through, every time I see her, she always wears a smile. Her smile is so contagious. Amen. That it makes you want to, well, it makes me want to smile. That even sometimes when I come and I feel like smiling, she's always, her smile will always bring me up. Amen. I am so proud to call her my sister in Christ. She's also my boo. That's our nickname for each other. Ever since I moved here 5 years ago. Well, this, it's not about me, but I'm getting to the point. Amen. Ever since I moved here about 5-6 years ago, that was what she called me. She introduced me to her husband. The first time I met her, I was, oh, babe, this is my boo thing from church. And so ever since then, that's been our nickname. Amen. For each other. And so tonight, I am so blessed and so proud to introduce our speaker. Please give her a warm welcome, a round of applause for none other than our Miriama Fuala'au team.
Praise the Lord. Well, what introduction. Thank you. Greetings to you all in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. My name is Miriama, as she mentioned. I have 5 beautiful babies, my oldest being my only son, and I have 4 beautiful young ladies. My amazing husband, who I'm very thankful for. Some days more than the other, but life is good. God is good, that's why. I'm not a licensed preacher. I'm actually not a licensed anything. I'm merely a servant. I'm here just to share a message that God put in our hearts, our officers' hearts. Our theme for this Mother's Day is a God-fearing woman. Proverbs 31, verse 30 and 31. So, I'm so sorry, please bear with me if I get stuck or just pray for me while you're sitting there, please. Okay. So if we can all turn our Bibles to Proverbs 31, please. I wish I could do the bilingual thing like First Lady does, where she translates in Samoan and English, but I'm not there yet. I promise I will get there, but for now, I will be speaking in English. It's not my first language. Samoan is my first language, but because I was raised here in the States, I kind of adapted more towards the American way. So Proverbs 31. So the title for our message tonight is A Proverbs 31 Woman. So we actually didn't plan on sharing about the same, in the same chapter, in the same book, but we knew to connect everything that we did today for Mother's Day to Proverbs 31. Because how many Proverbs 31 women do we have in the house tonight? Let me see your hand. Yes. Yes, we are Proverbs 31 women. And if we aren't yet, we are becoming Proverbs 31 women. I have faith in every single one of you, as well as myself. We are all still growing, and you are never alone. Remember that. So, the title for our message tonight is A Proverbs 31 Women. woman, sorry. There are three things that I wanted to share about, three main points, or three main focuses. Number one is, who is she? So, the Proverbs 31 woman is known as the virtuous woman, as Pastor shared this morning, or as First Lady shared, the God-fearing woman. So, when virtuous means excellence. So, if you take excellence and put it in our title, or at the title of our message, an excellent woman. I know our minds are like, that's impossible. How can we be excellent women? We're just human. But because of the God that we serve, because of this word right here, because of our praying, because of our fasting, because even our husbands and our children, they honestly push us to be the better us. And because of that, we are becoming Proverbs 31 women. So who is she? Let's get back. Before we dig in, let me take us in a word of prayer. Father, thank you for your word that we are about to receive. I pray that every word that I speak, that everything that I do is aligned with your will. I pray that your word will go forth, because it will go forth, Father, and it will fall and do exactly what it is meant to do. I thank you for everyone that is here tonight. Bless their hearts, Father. Soften their hearts to receive your word. Let it fall on good soil. Help us to grow only in you. In your precious name, Jesus, amen. Okay, so we can go ahead. I think she's going to shoot it up here. Proverbs 31, and we will start from verse 10 all the way to 27. It will be in English. If we can all read it together, please. Who can find a virtuous and capable wife? She is more precious than rubies. Her husband can trust her, and she will greatly enrich his life. She brings him good, not harm, all the days of her life. She finds wool and flax and busily spins it. She is like a merchant ship, bringing her food from afar. She gets up before dawn to prepare breakfast for her household and plan the day's work for her servant girls. She goes to inspect the field and buys it. With her earnings, she plants a vineyard. She is energetic and strong, a hard worker. She makes sure her dealings are profitable. Her lamp burns late into the night. Her hands are busy spinning bread, her fingers twisting fiber. She extends a helping hand to the poor and opens her arms to the needy. She has no fear of winter. Keep going. Oh, sorry.
She has no fear of winter. Her household, for everyone has warm clothes. She makes her own bedspreads. She dresses in fine linen and purple gowns. Her husband is well known at the city gates. When he sits with the other city leaders, she makes belted linen garments and fashions to sell to the merchants. She is clothed with strength and dignity, and she laughs without fear of the future. When she speaks, her words are wise, and she gives instructions with kindness. She carefully watches everything in her household and suffers nothing from laziness. Her children stand and bless her. Her husband praises her. There are many virtuous and capable women in the world, but Jesus surpassed them all. Charm is deceptive, and beauty does not last. But a woman who fears the Lord will be greatly praised. Reward her for all she has done. Let her deeds publicly declare her praise.
Amen. Good job, everyone. Thank you for that. So, who is she? So, husbands, do you know who your wife is? Children, do you know who your mom is? Are they the same person at home that they are in church? Are they the same person that in church that they are in the car before church?
Right.
Are they the same person that that's at home on their way to school, and then also the same mom that's at the field trips, the cool mom, or is she still the crazy mom like me? Okay. So in verse 11, It speaks about how she is trustworthy. Her husband can trust her. She is a protector of her family and home. She brings him good, not harm, all the days of her life. She is always ready to put in work, no matter what the cost. Even if it means we're on our last $10, we're still gonna give it so your kid can have lunch for school, right? So no matter what it is, you know, we will go to the ends of the earth for our children. We will go to the ends of the earth for our families, because that is the Jesus in us. That is the God in us. He will do anything for us. And that is just the kind of love that we mothers have for not only our spouses, but especially for our children. Can I get an amen, kids?
Amen.
Amen. She is selfless. She is always putting others before her. I know it's hard. It gets kind of chaotic, and we always want to like give up. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
It's hard. It's very hard, but it's worth it. In the end, it is very worth it. She is full of life. She has the same energy all around. Not, I'm alive and well in church. At home, give me my blanket, hon. Hon, can you give me the remote over there, hon? Can you make my food? Honey, stop. So, she has the same energy all around. So the same energy that you have here in church, the same energy you should have at home. In fact, it honestly starts from home. You cannot come and be someone totally different. I know you guys hear this all the time. Especially First Lady reminded us this morning, actions speak louder than words. We can say, oh, I'm Miriama Time from Tacoma, Washington, da-da-da, from Midway Assembly of God. But what do my actions really portray?
Yeah.
What are the words that are coming out of my mouth really say about me, who I am? So just like First Lady mentioned this morning, you can say nothing. Literally walk into a room full of people and just, they already know who you are.
Amen.
You don't even have to say anything because the works, her works, the Proverbs 31 woman's works speak for itself. Amen. Okay. She makes sure everything is as it should be. Stay organized, women. Stay organized, moms, especially moms. Stay organized. I know it's a tiring reminder, but it's a must, especially if we have children. We should always stay organized. Honestly, I'm the crazy OCD mom that organizes things the night before. And then I have my kids wake up early in the morning, and I want them to rest as long as possible. So my duty as a mom is to make sure that I'm organized and everything is well put, so that when they wake up, it's not so much them having to do what my job is for or what I am for as a mom, but that they can really enjoy their childhood, so that they can really enjoy growing up to be the pure hearted souls that they are meant to be. So for us moms, I encourage you to make their job easier as children. But children, please, make our jobs easier for us. If you know better, you
do better.
Amen. If you know better, you
do better.
And I know we all know better because we know Jesus.
Amen.
Okay, moving on. She is a hard worker. And I'm not just saying money hardworking, like having a job that actually pays hourly wage. I'm talking about she is a hard worker all around. Whether it is at home, whether it is an actual workplace, whether it is just even without children, just a woman, period, you know, that has no spouse or children, she is a hard worker. If you want something, obviously you work hard for it. You can't, faith without works is dead. So of course we want to pray about things, that we want things to come to fruition, but we have to put in the work as well. So all my Proverbs 31 women, are you a hard worker?
Yes!
I know you are. I always see it day in and day out.
Yes!
Even without a paying job. Money is nothing compared to the joy that our families bring to us. Amen. She is strong. Come what may, she is strong. It says, she is strong, and she's, and in verse 17 it says, she is energetic and strong, a hard worker. Her, 19, her hands are busy spinning thread, her fingers twisting fiber. If you honestly go through this list, it is very tiring, like First Lady mentioned. It's very overwhelming. How many of us get overwhelmed? Like, literally, I get overwhelmed every other day. But it's good overwhelm. It's not bad overwhelm. It's really good overwhelm. And so, sorry, I lost. So she is a hard worker. In her home and out of her home, wherever she goes, she is hardworking. Like even with how the photo went, like even that, just things like that, where you can serve. Just serving is actually hardworking as well. Like not a lot of us want to be a slave, like Pastor says, because to the world, a slave means
bondage.
Poor, bondage, no identity. But to us, to Christians, being a slave is the best thing ever that's ever happened to us.
Yeah.
Because it's never about us.
Right.
It's all about God.
Amen.
And so we always want to be, we don't want to be slaves to our families, but to be a slave of God means submit to your husbands, care for your children. Even on the days you don't want to, you still do it. So, amen.
Amen.
I'm sorry, please bear with me. She is the first one up and the last one down. How many of us are early birds? Yes, Rowena. Yes, Aunt Teresa. Yes, some of us don't have a choice. Actually, we do have a choice. We have a choice to stay in bed and do nothing, let your kids miss school, let them take care of themselves, make their own food. But we're not like that, right? Proverbs 31 women,
yeah.
We are not like that. We keep the same energy all around. So the same energy that we have for everyone else. And I know this is, I'm getting sidetracked. I know this is a big thing. I used to do it, honestly, I'm speaking from experience. I used to treat other people better than my husband. I used to speak nicely to other people. And I would talk to my husband, he would automatically irritate me. And like, then I'd have to catch myself, like, what? Why are you talking like that? He did nothing to you. So it's like, honestly, it's a growing process. But we are more than able to do it. We are more than capable and able to do it. I'm sorry, I got sidetracked. So she is the first one up and the last one down. So we wake up early and we're the last ones to go to bed. Even when we have only 2 hours of sleep before church, we are still the last ones down. I have this crazy thing where I learned from my dad, where I go and lock up our house, like windows, everything, doors. And even in the middle of the night when it's like 3 a.m, I will still go up to my son's room, make sure his doors, windows are closed, make sure the bathroom's, like, it's just who we are. It's like a mother's nature. But also because it's sound mind, you want to be protected. Okay. Amen, everyone. Is everyone still awake?
Yes.
You guys are just laughing at me, huh? Okay. She takes care of everyone and anyone. She helps her husband out any way she can, whether it is financially, whether it is spiritually, whether it is anything. She just helps him out. We were created, like Pastor mentioned this morning, we were created from Adam's rib. So we are the help. When people say the help, it's like slavery, right? Like, we always make fun of beauty and we call her the help because she's apagasi. But it's not funny, but it's funny because we get each other like that. The love is more real than, it's not real. No, I meant it. Never mind. Okay, moving on. She is always mindful treating others the way she wants to be treated.
Yes.
Do you treat others the way you want to be treated, women?
Yes.
Men, do you treat others the way you want to be treated?
No.
Oh, someone's personal. Someone said no about their husband. Children, do you treat others the way you want to be treated? Yes. So if you want respect, you give respect. If you want love, you... Actually, no, we should love anyways. Because, yeah, that's who we are. Christ-like. Love, no matter what. No matter what they do, no matter what they say. Love, love, love. Repeat after me. Love.
Love.
Love. Love your neighbors as you love yourself. She doesn't speak foolishly. She is wise and careful and is always kind. I know it's so hard to be kind, especially when you're trying to rush out of the house and it's getting busy and kids are late for the bus and your husband's late for work, no lunch. I know it gets crazy, but the words that come out of our mouth and the actions that and what our actions are, they speak volumes. And it should always portray Jesus.
Yes.
And Jesus is always patient.
Amen.
He is kind. He is self-control. Lots of self-control, Lord. Lots of self-control. So basically the fruit of the Spirit. Fruits of the Spirit. So I encourage you, pray. I do this all the time. I pray for the fruits of the Spirit. Especially patience. Like lots of patience. Okay. She is not lazy. We are not lazy women.
Yes.
No, we are not.
No,
I rebuke any spirit of laziness in any of us, that, even on our bad days, we cannot be lazy. Amen?
Amen.
We can be tired. It doesn't say you can't be tired, right? No, we can be tired. But that's why God gave us a sound mind to do what it is that we need to do when we need to do it and not wait last minute and then drown ourselves in tiredness. Okay, now we're moving on to our second point. Are you guys still awake? Can I get a say? Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Amen. What does she do? So what does a Proverbs 31 woman do? So as we read, she does that. Honestly, what does she not do, right? What do we not do? So, but it's not about us. It's all of everything we do should point to Jesus. So, but honestly, what does she do? A Proverbs 31 woman does so much and anything, honestly, that she can. Because that is the heart that we have, is to serve people, to put others above us.
Yeah.
Especially our spouses, especially our children. I know it gets hard. I know it gets tiring. I know it gets very tiring, but I'm telling you, it is very well worth it.
Amen.
So what does she do? She does everything out of love. And love is everything that she does comes out of her heart, right? Because that's where we love from, is from our hearts, right guys? So she does everything out of love. And the best example, honestly, the most amazing love is that God gave his only son for you and I. And honestly, it's hard to even think to give up a child. Like, I know we can say, we feel like, oh, that's easy. I will die for my children. God take me, don't take my children. But honestly, when the time comes, are you really willing and able to do that? Because God did it for us. He's a parent just like us. Whether he is a woman or not, he did it. And I believe that everything that us women do, even if you don't even have a child, even you young women, everything you do, when you do it out of love, it's so much more rewarding. Like, just getting, you don't even have to get anything in return. Just knowing that you are a blessing to someone else and that you are putting someone else above yourself is much more rewarding than anything. And that's what I love about God's love for us, because he gave his only son for us. And the last point is, are you she? And it's as in she, I'm talking about the Proverbs 31 woman. Are you a Proverbs 31 woman? I know it's hard. I know it gets very hard and very, very, very tiring. But in verse 28 it says, her children stand and bless her. Her husband praises her. I know that everything that we do, a lot of people say, oh, I do it for my family. But honestly, to me, when I die, I don't care for a legacy. I want my children and my husband and everyone that came in contact with me to know that it's Jesus. It was God in me. It was Him in me. And it was never me. It was never about me. It's not about any of us. But it is about the God in us. And so I just want to encourage you, like, I'm sorry. That it is worth it. It is definitely worth it. I've always heard of the Proverbs 31 woman, but being assigned to preach tonight, I actually got to go through each of these. And really, like, I read over them over and over and over again. And it was, there's honestly so much to say about it. There's so much to learn from. There's so much that we can work to become. And I know that you guys, some of you have heard this many times, this Proverbs 31 woman. But every time, God's word can never be, it never gets old. It never gets old. So every time you read it, or every time you hear it, or every time you even see it, Proverbs 31 woman, it's so encouraging. It's so, something new comes to you. Like a new understanding. God gives us a new understanding each and every time. And I love that so much about it. Because I started off with just one main topic. And then I went to like five words. It was like every time throughout the week I was reading it over and over, I kept getting new ideas, something new was coming to me. But I thank God because it really teaches me to stay ready. It really teaches me to stay ready no matter what. It, even if it's good or if it's bad, to stay ready, come what may. Because a Proverbs 31 woman is very hard to, she's actually not a real woman. Pastor mentioned this morning, it's actually King Lemuel's mother who told him all of this stuff, who was saying all this stuff. And so she's not even a real woman, it's experiences throughout her life. And so I encourage you, if you feel like you're not doing something on this list, it's okay, it's not the end of the world. We are all growing, we are all learning. And that's the beauty of God, is that of God's love, is that it's forever. And we can keep trying, like we can keep getting into it, we can keep going. Like we shouldn't give up, especially if you're still here. There's still so much time left for you while you still have air in your lungs, and while you still have, while you still can walk and talk, and you're still able to go somewhere. So ladies, turn to your right and ask your neighbor, are you she? Oh, now you guys, I'm sorry. I'm so sorry, guys. Lastly, I'm sorry. Feels kind of long. Lastly, the most beautiful part about the Proverbs 31 woman is she is greatly praised. Charm is deceptive and beauty does not last, but a woman who fears the Lord will be greatly praised. Reward her for all she has done. Let her deeds publicly declare her praise. Like I mentioned earlier, everything that we do, it's worth it. Everything that we are is all because of God. It's all because of this word, all because of prayers. So I encourage you to keep going and to pray for me as I pray for you, and to uplift each other and encourage each other to be Proverbs 31 women, and to not look down on each other, even if you're young or old or if you have a title or not. I encourage us all, like, we're all Proverbs 31 women. Whether we feel like it or not, some days are good, some days are bad. But because of the God that we serve, it's so worth it to keep trying. It's so worth it to keep going. And I love you guys, and I'm so thankful to be a part of the Midway Samoan Assembly of God. Thank you, Pastor, for this opportunity. Thank you, First Lady and Sister Fuala'au, and my fellow officers, for entrusting me with such an opportunity. It should never be taken lightly, and I just thank God for this opportunity. I pray that you guys are blessed. I pray that you guys leave here better than you came. Whether it is through the word, I'm hoping it's through the word, but whether it is now or even the ending of service, I pray that you are blessed. I pray that you are blessed in your coming and your going, especially in your homes, where it matters. Like Pastor Owen says, healthy families, healthy church. Healthy families, healthy church. And it's so real. It's so real. We can come and pretend all we want, but what's out there, who you are out there, is really what matters.
Amen.
I love you guys, and in Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Amen. Of the message of what it means to be a Proverbs 31 woman. Olha a minha foi lá e tu com mais dito tomo no noto. Lá na família e pepelo e lá. E ele mata um filho. E fata o lá a foi lá. Lá lá de lei. Lá e tato fa pé ma na e te fio e teu teu fa fo se tu lou. Aí lê ma fai na ganga aí lou noto. Lá na foi pé o na o ina. Olha baba aí lê tu lê tu tu sem mal baba aí o tanata. O tanata na e hip mai fa fole baba aí a lê tua. A sila sila mai a te oi lê tina fa pé foi lê tama. E ti lo si lo sa o e lo noto. Me la na ye fata o le tina le feme o tina e mataku ile e tua. O le tina e a mi o le le la le feme e le fwe feme tu i fata oto. I e sili o na leo leo ina lo wa. Lo noto a ise a lango i le tupo ma ele a mi o. A faila le a mi o le pe tala no ta e au le sa tala no e le fine le no ya ruta. Le na feme na a noto ya moasa e fesili a tupo asa po a ile le fine. Tell what you know, your router or your router, if I made a tell upon some, yeah. Why, Lord, my Luya Lele, or oil safe a fine army on the lane. If I tell you to see a router, a light must have made our way router, I may not tell you to Tanato, yes, a fine lane. I own on the man wake up. Tina, to Famalos here to Yati Oi, Ben Famalos here to Poy Mili, Fapo Tina, Falemana Tai out. E sili ona le otele lo wa mio yo upo mau fantalama. A wane itele vabe tato fantalama. Nama peo na tamu fai foe. Nama ia se tu lo ulaba. Ai lama la mea lama wa uto fai te au tau lama tau tala tu. Tu sai man mele e te lo fala ve lave o te le foe o mea tupu. Ona o le tau tala lama fine. A lot of issues is because we talk a lot. We spread rumors. Now, excuse me, I understand this might be stepping on people's toes, but I cannot stop from preaching the word of God. Melania Tina, if I take a love of your tongue fire to a nea so I saw, or the fine to a ceiling of your fear, my ailer to a near fear of my ailer to a matter my lona lotto and our mule lay. Starts from within. Beyond tongue fire 2 million, and they say, oh, now, low, leo, kele, eel, falisa. I owe a quick fall, oh, a puffan, like it, okay, you're going to allow valia.
Yeah.
Well, maybe you can make it confusing, look. And then you try to force them to worship. But they know who you are at home.
Amen.
See, you need to be the same person in church and the same person at home.
Amen.
Otherwise, you confuse your kids. That also goes along with your respect and your relationship with your husband. And a lot of time, even though Judah is still a baby, but even in those moments, when Judah's in or around, or it's in the car that it's happening and Judah's in the back, we have this little rule that we will just, as angry as we are, we just wait until Judah's not in the car. In this kind of atmosphere where we're constantly arguing, how do you think Judah's going to grow up and feel? He's going to follow the same footsteps. And so I encourage us mothers, be very, very careful. You have a big role. Let me tell you what to name. Ole fafita yatu. Lama kele kele na bena oto. I may see level to tono la aina le ngate la aina le kale si e le fale o maina e momoli yatu mato anana faftai. I know my mom too. I thank her because she's done a lot of crazy things for us too, keeping us in check. We weren't the best kids, but she did whatever she could, and I'm sure that's the testimony of many of us children. But at the end of the day, everything should always point back to the cross and who Jesus is. The reason why they can be the mothers that they are, I don't want us to look down on them as because, you know, like she said, the help. You know, I get it, you know, but you know what, man? God looked down and saw how lonely Adam was and said, it's not good for him to be alone. And so if God himself understood that this wasn't good, let's not look down on our mothers. God knew that we needed help. And there's a reason why he made him out of our womb or rib instead of making her separately. It's because at the end of the day, when the woman comes and when you get married, the Bible says, once you're married, you leave your parents and you become one with your wife. What does that mean? It means that your wife is not standing behind you. It doesn't mean that your wife is standing in front of you, but your wife comes alongside you and you become one. I love what one theologian said, when your wife comes to your side, the rib is coming home. And it's that idea that you work together as one.
Amen.
So I encourage you, wives, love your husbands. Don't make them look bad. Sometimes I hear this, o isi te mi o te fa'alomo, o te fia fa'amalusi atu ya te oe, a fainyo tau tinonga, a faifungi o fa'amtalanga, a wake sawi e ta'u valea, pe ta'u leanga ye lo tolua. It's not good. Because le familia tu si enta to feme a o atu me no lo fai toi ina e lo ai ono le a ono le leo lo me tofua a le le a ono le no fono fa tu sto ina ile va to e ina ai la fai mai uma casa le fu le to lo e tua e sto ina e le le fo la no fa ma la fo la mo mo e sta ma va e sta ma le ya le fa no e so ka le va pe ya le o ka la me no pe ni ka le o sa you hear that? Okay, fa no mo so fa ka la no fa pe na careful church. We may think it's funny, but when you're degrading your husband, you're not doing them any good. Make sure we learn to respect our husbands. And then the women got quiet. And they say, "Upa lupa tusfaia." Say, "Amen." Lama foyo fatatia iya tusfaia ole tamao le unuraenga. Say, "Amen." Pete fia fia i pete le fia fia i lama tusfaia le afioma paia le atua. He is the head of the church. But again, this is not to pick on you women. We love you guys, but it's an encouragement for you. Respect your husbands, and also please your children. Your children was not given to you so they can do your fa'aus. Oh, I know some of you are like, no. That's the fa'asamoa way. If you can tell me anywhere in the Bible that says that, show me. But I'll tell you right now, there's no scripture in the Bible that says your children are there to do your fa'aus. No, it says that they are a gift from God. A gift from God that it says it's like an arrow. If I to say now for me, and there are arrows that you shoot out. Shoot out to do what? To do the will of God. Can I just step on some toes tonight and say that, do you know, sometimes we're wondering why our children are not coming to church? It's because probably we're too tight keeping them in, you know, keeping them to ourselves. The Bible talks the opposite, that we are to release our children so that they can do the will of God. But some of us, sometimes we hold on too tight. And we don't allow God to use the kids. The only reason why I can be here today is because my parents decided a long time ago, at the age of 16, God, use them for your will. Whatever you want to do with him, use him. And I'm the product of their prayers tonight because they decided to release me into the will of God. Amen. I want to encourage you, mothers, don't hold on too tight. There's a time that you need to release them so that they can go and do the will of God.
Yeah.
Say amen. Because you're not going to raise them forever. You raise them up so that they can be released to do the will of God. And if there are some children that you feel like they're just gone in the world, a mother's job never ends. You keep praying until they come back to God. My brothers, they all know. Every time at night she comes and we would feel her cold hands when we were asleep. And she would just pray for us. We didn't understand at the time what she was doing. But she would just pray over us. Not knowing that God would have his way over our lives. So we thank God for your job, moms. We know it's not an easy task. But I want to encourage you. Continue doing a good work for the Lord. Say amen. Continue praying for your children. Continue serving your husbands. Loving your husbands. Say amen, husbands. Love your husbands. Husbands, love your wives just as Christ loved the church. Say amen. Being a husband doesn't mean dictatorship. Being a husband means responsibility. It means you are the head of the family. You are the priest of the family. Because you are the priest of your family. And like the Bible says, But just to add on to what she's saying, because you look at this list and you think it's impossible, I will tell you it's possible through Jesus. Proverbs 31. And so it is through this that he's understanding this is the kind of wife that you need to be looking for. Any single men in the house? No single men in the house? If you are single, ask your mom who is a good woman. Say amen. Reading the Bible and check it out. The word of God is there. Say amen. Mataava single?
Yeah.
Find a virtuous single. Yeah. Hallelujah. I love you. Yeah, I will say. Amen. Women, we tip our hats off to you. You guys have a very hard job, but we want to encourage you. If you are a single mother, well, I want to take the time to also say, way to go, hanging in there. I believe, single moms. And it's one of the craziest things, because if you look in America, one of the leading problems in America today are broken families. There's a lot of broken families.
Yeah.
That's why we're believing that as a church, we need to begin at this point here by healing our local families before we can go and try to expand out and reach other people. We need to start within our own church. So we're praying that over the next years or so, we're not going to be quick to rush out and do anything. We're going to begin by building our church families. Say amen. Because when we get healthy here, it's easy to spread. But it's hard to preach the word out there, but our families in the church are broken. So I need your help. I need us to all pray because we need to have healthy families. Say amen. We're going to try and build here first because once this place is solid, then we can open up the doors and spread the gospel of Jesus Christ. Say amen. But we need healthy families. Young men who aren't married yet, be responsible in who you decide to marry. Say amen. Rise up and take responsibility. Let's not be quick just to, you know what I'm going to go with, but let's just be careful in that situation. I believe that's a reason why there's such a high feminist movement in America, is because a lot of our young men are being irresponsible. So let's be responsible. Say amen. My moms, if you are taking care of your children, continue to pray. I'm telling you, there is power in prayer. Stop trying to do it on your own strength, wisdom, and knowledge. That's why you often fail. That's why you often cry. But lean on God. How do you lean on God? Just pray. There's no fancy way of praying. You don't need to say all these heavenly words. Just like how we're communicating, communicate to God and talk to Him. Have you read the book of Psalms? You think God can't handle your craziness? God can handle it. He can take care of it. There is no detail too small for God. There is nothing too big for God. That's the God that we serve. And He has enough grace for every situation that you're in tonight. Say amen. Whatever situation you find in, don't give up. Turn to your neighbor and tell your neighbor, don't give up. Hang tight. The best is yet to come. Turn to your neighbor and say, the best is yet to come. Amen. Do you believe that tonight? Let's give a hand for God tonight. Come. Amen. Your last part of the program today, for the rest of the night. But let's give it up for our women's ministry one more time.
Praise the Lord. Amen. So, women's ministry, Midway Samoan Assembly of God, it is now your time. Praise God. Let's welcome the women's ministry here at Midway. Give them a round of applause. Thank you.
Proverbs 31, Ia.
Proverbs 31, verse 30, 31. Proverbs 31, verse 30, 31.
Charm is deceitful and beauty is vain, but a woman who fears the Lord is to be praised. Give her the fruit of her hands and let her works praise her in the gates.
But also it's all to me to ask Ia.
But also it's all to me to ask Ia.
My feet are still on fire. God is good. God is good, church.
All the time.
All the time.
God is good.
We're going to get ready to do a skit this evening. One of the ladies who came to Jesus Christ, but she recognized that she needed help and she needed hope. And so tonight, the life atino ina atu ele mtama tina, o se tina wa iloa emanaumia ilono langa Yesu Kristo. She needs Jesus in her life. And when she recognizes this, this is when she realizes about the power of forgiveness. Ele se isi tana te mawa ita atomle le mana le o le faa maangalo. Wana o Yesu Kristo, le faa maangalo ino ata atoma masala. So I encourage you tonight, no matter how big or small or how great or kind of bad your life has been, tonight we will just want to encourage you that with Jesus, everything is possible. So I pray that you may be blessed with our skit this evening. Aye, fa mo dia mai le tu le nei afi afi ona Yesu. Amen.
Thank you.
Person who can forgive our sins, the only person in which we can find our true identity. She knew it would be in Jesus Christ. That's why she's nameless, because she knew that it wasn't about her and what she was doing. It was about putting Jesus at the forefront, understanding that it's all about Him. He's the only one who can forgive my sins. He's the only one in whom my identity is found. We have an identity crisis in our nation today. People are looking. They want to know. But tonight, I hope that you would be encouraged. You want to find your identity. Why look around the world when you should look at the one who created you? You know what your purpose is in this world, but I'm telling you, start in the right place. Start with God. After all, He's the one who made you. And if He's the one that created us, it only makes sense that He would also have the purpose for your life. Say amen. You're not here by accident. No matter what the world tells you, you're not here. Lord, Ale mea nai te iloa ima e tātou si la fia e ao ngā oi le fina ngalo le atua. E leo se eskeni lo iai le pōnei, e leo se eskeni lo soifua mai le neitai ni olo tātou iai. Ai se a lango le atua le soifua na alofa ia, le whamei na maliu Yesu, maliu a Yesu, malanga iloa o tōu lea. That's why it says when he was on the cross, you and I were on his mind. And you know what the funny thing is, I always say this, if he knew that you and I were in mind, Jesus also knew that some of us in here would reject what he's done on the cross. But that didn't stop him from dying. He died anyway, knowing that some of us in here would reject him. I don't know what that is to you, but that is love. It's a crazy sense of love, but he loved you so much. Why? Because maybe he was just hoping. Maybe he was hoping that one day, just someday, you would open up your hearts and allow him to become King and Lord and Savior over your life. And tonight, as the skit was portrayed, that's what I'm reminded of. A nameless woman, yet we talk about her story. Why? Because this nameless woman found her identity in Jesus Christ. See, the world always tells us what we need to do to succeed. Do you know what the Bible tells us? John says, I must decrease so that Jesus can increase. See, because when you go, I don't know if you've been to a concert, and whenever you go to a concert, there's usually that one show that happens before the concert. They're not the main show. They're not the main attraction. It's just a pre-show, but it's leading up to the main event. You see, as a church, that's what we are. The main person is Jesus. We're not here to increase our name. Tato te leo mai, e vivi in tato e moa, vivi in le suapa, pe vivi i foile i mole e ka le sia, mo le fa tots kotonga le atua, tasi i lava le suapa, nanga ele maliu se e ka le sia mo oe, ele maliu se tangata mo oe, aina maliu Yesu keriso mo oe ma. Mea nao te whama alo sezo, au te manatu foile le li tala, is tangata ia nofa o tapa. Some of us, we're afraid to accept Jesus because we're worried about what other people might say. Let me help you. The people that are talking about you all the time, they are not willing to lay down their lives for you, just as Jesus did. Yes. And so as I call up the worship team, I would be remiss, because I sense that in here, in this place, that there are some of us that we need to really, really consider giving our lives to Jesus Christ. Yeah. And I'm not going to force you, because at the end of the day, I'm not going to take you to heaven. But our jobs as a pastor is to help point you to the right direction, lead you to the right place, so that you can stop wasting your time in the temporary things of this world. Aren't you tired of it? Doing the same thing over and over and over, expecting different results, but come back to the same thing every single day. Let me help you tonight. Jesus is the only answer for you. Jesus is the only one that can truly, truly satisfy your every need. But don't take my word for it. You need to step in and taste for yourself. That's what David said. Taste for yourself and see how good God is. Do you know what that means? See, I can tell you about a good restaurant down the road. Hey, have you heard about this restaurant? The reason why I talk about this restaurant is because I've actually sat down and I've tasted the food. But see, you won't know how good the food is until you go to that restaurant and you actually sit down, order something on that menu, and taste the food for yourself so that you yourself know that the food is good. This is what David means by taste for yourself and see that the Lord is good. You cannot live through what I know. You cannot live through what your parents know. You cannot live through what someone else tells you. I can preach till my face is blue, but at the end of the day, it's up to you to make that decision. I can't lead you to the cross. I can't save you. Only God can do that. But I want to give you an opportunity. Because here's the thing. And when it's done, it's when you die. And here's the thing, nobody in here knows when they're gonna die. You can't tell me and say, I'm gonna die in 2 days or I'm gonna die in 3 days. That's up to God. But here's the thing, when you die, if death comes knocking on your door, here's the greatest question, which side of eternity will you be on? There is an eternal hell and there is an eternal heaven. And when we die, that's all that matters. Legacy,